If you will, repeat after me to God.
Then he appeared to more than
Thank you for reading of the scripture. We ask that you remain standing as we pray on this particular topic. We preach so you believe in the power of the resurrection. We preach so you believe in the power of the resurrection. Let us pray. Father, it's preaching time. And Lord, as always, I need you. Prop me up on every side. Allow your glory to shine through my vocals, that the church may be edified with the word of God. We need to hear a word from you. So open up our eyes that we may see Jesus behind the work in our life. Open up our ears that we may hear a word from you. Then, oh Father, open up our hearts that your word may be safely lodged in the repository thereof. And no matter where we are, your word arises and helps us to meet every occasion. This, oh God, is our humble prayer, and it is in Jesus' name that we do pray. And as God's children, we say, Amen. May be seated in the presence of an almighty God. We preach so you believe in the power of the resurrection. My brothers and sisters, the cross was a time of victorious death. It's a negative triumph. Sin was indeed defeated, but nothing positive was put in its place until after the resurrection. The resurrection showed that Jesus did not succumb to the ordinary result of sin. Even though he had no sin, sin was placed upon him for us. The Bible teaches that he became sin for us. And the resurrection is the proof of his conquest, not only over death, but also over sin. But then the Bible teaches also that he rose again on the third day. The fact that Jesus rose again the third day is part of the gospel. You see, you must understand, my brothers and sisters, Jesus' case of rising from the dead was unique. He didn't just get up in a general resurrection. He got up on time because he told everybody that he was going to be buried, that he was going to first die, then be buried, and raised from the dead. I can tell you when remember in Psalms 22 when it cried out, Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? He had to have a sense of God forsaking him so that we can know how we feel when we feel like God ain't nowhere around. And I'm so glad it's only a feeling that God is nowhere around, because I got good news. I read somewhere that he said he'll never leave me nor forsake me. But every now and then, and if I just be honest with myself, it'll seem like he's nowhere around. But I'm so glad that he is. You see, the plan for his resurrection is also described in Hosea, the 6th chapter, verse 2, and it's also as a scenario in Genesis, the 22nd chapter, where Isaiah, as a type of Christ, is raised on the third day of the journey, at the beginning of which Abraham had already reckoned him to be dead. Y'all gonna pray with me today? We've got to understand that yet there are other passages of hope and confidence after this. Don't you remember that Job in the 19th chapter, verse 25 through 27 says, "For I know that my Redeemer liveth, and that he shall stand at the latter day upon the earth. And though after my skin worms destroy this body, yet in my flesh shall I see God, whom I shall see for myself, and my eyes shall behold, and not another, though my reins be consumed within me." You see, you got to understand that resurrecting from the dead was not something that was just taught in the New Testament. It was already being established in the Old Testament. I heard a good person say that the Old Testament conceals, but the New Testament reveals. Are y'all going to with the cross. Because he got up out of the grave. The tomb wasn't open for him to get out. It was open so the rest of the world could get in to see that he was gone. They didn't steal his body. 500 witnesses ain't gonna lie. Somebody said, well, why didn't they talk about the news? You gotta understand the culture of the time. A woman's testimony wasn't counted for much. But that's why Jesus used the women to take them up another notch for what society was trying to say. Don't you dare say a woman can't preach. Don't you say it. Because a woman wouldn't preach to those scared preachers hiding in the room and told them, come see him. He's alive, just like he said. Come see the place where they laid. He's not there, for he is risen. Am I right about it? And you gotta understand, we preach. It's the foolishness of preaching that are saved souls. You can talk all day long, but you gotta preach. You gotta bring around some preaching. You gotta bring around some teaching, which means you need to know something yourself. You need to be always ready to give an account of what you believe in. Amen? So that you can share the gospel. So that folks can get to the place and they say, I'm what you got. And don't you dare tell them what you got is you. You pulled yourself up by your bootstraps. The story was told of a fella named Blue up in Chicago way. And this fella named Blue, if you wanted prostitution, he was the go-to man. If you wanted some drugs, he knew how to hook you up. If you wanted some lotto tickets, some of y'all don't know about running numbers, he was the man to go ahead and get it for you. And if you crossed him, they were liable to find you somewhere then. But after a while, it was an old girlfriend of his that was looking for old Blue. And she couldn't find old Blue. A week went by. Another week went by. She began to ask for Red Blue. And another week went by. Here, after about a month or two, she found somebody that saw me and said, yeah, I love you, go. And so she ran to the end of the corner. And when she got to the end of the corner, it wasn't nothing there but a church. Y'all don't hear me. And she said, sure, he couldn't be in there. But she went in. And when she got in the door, Blue didn't say nothing. He just gave her a program. Y'all ain't hear me. The preacher, before he preached, they were saved. And so after they saw the preacher preach, when the door of the church was open, she come walking down there. And he said, did you come because of this big, beautiful church? She said, no. He said, well, did you come up front because of the choir that was singing? He said, no. And he stuck his chest out. He said, well, you come because I preach so well to motivate you to come. She said, no. He said, well, what was it? He said, I had There could be somebody here that needs to know the man that took a drug dealer off the street. Somebody needs to know the man that pulled a prostitute off the car. Somebody here needs to know a man that took a liar and made it not tell the truth. If you're here today and you don't know Jesus, we don't preach and get all sweaty for nothing. We preach so that you'll believe that Jesus died for your sins. That Jesus was raised from the dead so that you can live now and forevermore. If you're here today, you don't know him. Now's the time to come. Don't put it off any longer. I did what I was going to do. I feel so much better. Amen. I don't know who you like it, but I believe you'd be satisfied. I want to be able to tell his story. If you're here today, now's the time. Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior. Believe that he died for your sins and God raised him from the dead. He lives now and forevermore. If you want to do that, now is the time to come. There could be someone you know you're saved and you're looking for a church home. God has led you here. Now is the time. You can come by letter. You can come by Christian experience. You can come as a candidate for baptism. How do you come? Now is the time. Nobody says that it's promised to you.